as a bocher in 770, just came back from Australia on Shlichus. We're looking forward in anticipation and excitement for this great day of Yud Shvat, Shnasa Esrim. There's a lot of excitement in the year. Bocher undertook to learn 20 Maimorim, put on film with 20 people. This was going on. Then all of a sudden, suddenly, Erev Rosh Chodesh Shvat, the Rebbe came back from the Eil, and he called in Rabbi Simpson. And the Rebbe told him that all the hagbolas, all the limitations relating to the siyum of Sefer Torah Shel Mashiach has been removed. We can go on with the siyum of the Sefer Torah, and they should notify Eretz Yisrael and make a big pirsum about it. Immediately, they printed up special forms to register for the Sefer Torah. And on it was also written on the top of the form that Yilichenu Kveid Dushas Admushalita Kemimiyas Latzein. That the Rebbe should take us to Eretz Yisrael, Karev Mamush. That itself made a lot of excitement. Erev Yud Shvat itself, Rabbi Simpson went down the steps together, the Rebbe following. Rabbi Simpson was carrying the Sefer Torah, and the Rebbe was carrying a box. People had no idea what's in that box. Because we have to emphasize that in Lubavitch, in the whole Lubavitch, a Sefer Torah did not have a keser, didn't have a crown. Today, many Sefer Torahs have a crown, then none. So the Rebbe walked in with the box, people think, what's in that box? And the Rebbe put the box down on the table, and the Rebbe sat down, and the Sefer Torah was on the right-hand side of the Rebbe, and the box was on the left-hand side of the Rebbe. And the Rebbe said that Chan HaMokim, to invite all the Yidden in the world, B'chol Mokim Shehem, in Chutz Loretz, and Eretz Yisrael, the Yidden that Rabbi Shivye, B'motzer, B'tzoro, meaning in Russia, and the way to invite them is by saying the Mizmer of Lamnatzeach Yancha.
Kan ha-mokim af-onehed mit ha-zmone zu alle Jiden bechol mokim shehim as kama ve kama divas gefine zar b'shivya u b'tzoro u b'motze in ha-golus lifnimi golus was gafari der eifim ha-zmone Eichet al edei amira b'tzibur v'der Rebbe der Nossi hat geschrieben in eine von seinen Mechtorim Klolim de mizmer lam natzeach yancho.
And the Rebbe stood up and the Rebbe took his siddur and opened up lam natzeach yancho before of all the tzion and was pointing with the finger while Rebbe Shmuel was reading posuk by posuk. He read one pasuk and everybody repeated another pasuk and so on. After that, the Rebbe sat down, they sang the Nigunim of all the Rabbeim. The Rebbe asked specifically which Nigun to sing. By the Nigunim, by Frat, by the Alter Rebbe's name, we see on the Rebbe's face, Poshet, and Eilam Acher. After the Nigunim, the Rebbe stood up, and the Sefer, Mishmaya Factor, gave the Rebbe the kumis, the quill, and the Rebbe held on to it, and he gave it back to him, so he becomes a shliach of the Rebbe, to conclude the writing of the Sefer Torah. And while this was going on, while the writing was taking place, the last final words and letters, the Rebbe was constantly looking, didn't take his eyes off for a second from the letters and the being written by the Sefer. The Rebbe went over to the box that we mentioned before and put his hands all the way, both hands all the way deep into the box, and people were waiting to see what's going to happen, what's in that box. And all of a sudden, little by little, it started coming out because the box was pretty high. On top of that was flaps, also higher. So little by little, it was coming out. It was mamish, almost by the Rebbe's face. You saw a gleaming, shining, beautiful keser, which you never saw before, a keser. When it came up, it was mamish by the Rebbe's face. And the Rebbe took it and immediately went to the Sefer Torah. He put it on to the Sefer Torah. Then the Rebbe took the Sefer Torah and went to the Oren Kodesh to put it in. The Rebbe came back. Then the Rebbe sat down in his place and made Shechiyonu loud. Everybody was able to hear and answer Amen. The Rebbe ate a date. Then the Rebbe said a maimed. And the Rebbe started himself singing Tzomo Lecho Nafshi. And instead of singing Uscho Chveidecho, the Rebbe said Tufcho Vechazdecho. Two times, both times the Rebbe said Tufcho Vechazdecho. Motzei Shabbos is another verbringen. The Rebbe washed. The Rebbe said a maimer b'Osel Legani at night also. And the Rebbe gave out Kiddush L'Brocha at the end, which is something unusual. It happened very rarely that the Rebbe should give out Kiddush L'Brocha not on the Yom Tov.